Hello, my student. This is a teacher, Usman Francois. It's a 10 for mathematics. Now we are going to deal with the differentiation of trigonometric function. For differentiation, this is not the first time for doing differentiation or derivative, but now it is about trigonometric function. First, we are going to use first principle, Riemann definition. I think this first principle by using Riemann definition you have seen before. What is the materials that we are going to use? We are going to use limit of h tends to 0 sine h over h t z 1. Limit h tends to 0 tan h over h t z 1. Now, those formulas, I think you have seen this in chapter 1 of trigonometric function, and this is in CR 4. Now let us do our first example. Use first principle or limit to find the derivative of the following function. F of x is equal to sine x. Before, we have to choose one formula here for using in just performing such question. Now we have, we know that f of x, the derivative should be equal to the limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x over h. Our function f of x is equal to sine x. In this way, f of x is sine x. It means f of x plus h, this is sine x plus h. And now, by using sine h plus b, the formula we have here, so we can replace by using x, sine x plus h, by using this formula, this should be equal to sine x cos h plus cos x sine h. And now we have to replace this in the formula there, and h tends to 0, it is equal to sine x cos h, or we can even begin on this, sine x plus h as f of x plus h minus f of x, which is sine x over h. Now, f derivative of x, this is a limit h tends to 0 of sine x cos h plus cos h plus sine h cos x minus sine x over h. Now we can try to bring it here. From there, f derivative of x, you see, we have sine x and sine x. We can use the common factor h tends to 0. So we can take sine x here. Now we have cos h minus 1. Now plus this term, this is sine h cos x over h. F derivative of x, this is, you see, this is sine x and the variable left is h. We can take sine x here. We have a limit h tends to 0 cos h minus 1 over h plus, we can take cos x here. Yeah? Now we have a limit h tends to 0 of sine h over h. If we replace here, we can have cos h is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 over 0 is the termination case. And here we have it is 1. So f derivative of x, this is sine x, limit h h to 0. As we have this, we have to do the conjugation. It means cos h minus 1, cos h plus 1 over h, cos h plus 1. This is a conjugation. The things I multiply here is what I have to divide here. So now plus cos x times 1, as you have seen before in the definition. So we can try to clean this part. So we have cosine square h minus 1 over h cos h plus 1 now plus cos x. Now from here you see this is also 0 over 0, this is the termination case. So for removing this, we have to remind, you know, once you have cosine square h plus sine square h, this is 1. This is the fundamental formula in trigonometric function. So, as we can find it, cosine square h minus 1, this is minus sine square h. So, we are going to use this formula in our derivative. This is sine x limit h is to 0, I put minus sine square h over h cos h plus 1 plus cos x. In this format, we have f derivative of x. This is, I may take this negative in this form. Sine x as common factor, a limit of h goes to 0 of sine h times sine h as sine square over h cos h plus 1 now plus cos x. As you see, there is sine h over h. So we have minus sine x, limit h tends to 0 of sine h over h, this is 1 as we know, times limit h tends to 0 of sine h over cos h plus 1, now plus cos x. Have minus sine x, this is 1 times 1 times, this is sine 0, it is 0 over 2, this is 0, now plus cos x. This derivative of x will be cos x. This is our last. This is the method that we use when we are asked to find the derivative by using first principle, limit, or by using definition. This is the same terms. So let us try to do our second example. So we can begin here. This is our first example. Now try to see our second example. X is sine, for example, x. You are asked to find the derivative by using the definition, by using first principle. For just doing such question, f of x is equal to sine 2x. Before doing this, before finding this derivative, we are asked to find, we have to put the formula of derivative by using definition or by using first principle. It is a limit h is to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. After setting the formula, we can identify we have our f of x, this is sine 2x. Our f of x plus h should be equal to sine 2x plus h, which is equal to sine 2x plus 2h. And now, this is limit h tends to 0 of sine 2x plus h minus sine 2x over h. This is by definition. So f of derivative of x is limit h tends to 0 of sine